Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, wa lillahil hamd. Allahu akbar kabira, walhamdulillahi kathira, wa subhanallahi bukratan wa asila. Alhamdulillahi wahdahu la sharika lah, khalaqa fasawwa wa qaddara fahada, wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdah, wa ashhadu anna sayyidana Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh, وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وأنعم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه حق قدرهم ومقدارهم العظيم. وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء سيدنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وارض عنا معهم يا رب العالمين، آمين. ثم أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, dear elders and dear children, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you and give you the blessing of this day and the many days to come. As Muslims, we are so fortunate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us 2 days to celebrate. The first day, Eid al-Fitr, that comes after fulfilling the obligation of fasting, in which we deny ourselves the right to the food and the water. And that is big achievement. And the next one, what we are seeing today, Eid-Ul Adha, the day of sacrifice, the day in which we honor and celebrate our achievement by fulfilling the obligation of Hajj. Both occasions, brothers and sisters, are done for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Both occasions show the hijrah, that we migrate ourselves. We leave our necessity of life. We leave the food and the water. For today, the Hujjaj leave their homes, their countries, their families, their business, their wealth, everything, and they migrate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they march to the holy places of Mecca. There they honor the memory of the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. So today come as a prize for your achievement. Achievement to continue as a Muslim, the achievement to challenge your day-to-day life and to live to the best of your religion, the achievement to raise a family in this country, who's gonna be the future of Islam here in Toledo and North America. So your achievement today should continue forever. And that is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it shows in us to live among other people, other brothers and sisters. And it is all our responsibility to work as ambassadors for Islam. Whether you know it or not, you represent Islam in everything you say, in everything you do, with your neighborhood, in your work, with your friends, even with those who are against and racist and discriminate against you. You are the ambassador to show them what Muslims look like and how they show Islam as the most civilized, the most human, and the most caring religion. Yes, there are people who insult Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam here and abroad, even within our own Muslim countries. But our reaction should be same like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself. People used to call him names. And when his Sahaba got upset, said, Ya Rasulallah, Shall we give them the same names or answer them back? But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what wrong have they done? They call me Mudammam and Allah call me Muhammad. They try to insult me, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call me Muhammad. And Muhammad means the blessed one. So we remember Ibrahim alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him to a challenge his faith from day one, when his father used to be idol worshiper and the idol maker, and he has to grow up in this environment. So it doesn't matter what we say, look back at Ibrahim alayhi salam. The way he treated his father, never been harsh to him. Always say, Ya Abati, Ya Abati, Ya Abati. Ya Abati, la ta'budi shaytan. Inna shaytana kana lirrahman asiyya. Ya Abati, inni akhafu an yamassaka adhabun min arrahman. فتكون للشيطان وليا يا أبتي إني قد جاءني من العلم ما لم يأتك فاتبعني أهدك صراطا سويا. Always have respect يا أبتي, which means my dear father. That was Ibrahim عليه السلام. That Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم came to resemble the manners and the etiquettes of Ibrahim عليه السلام, how to deal with others who do not like us, who have a bad idea about Islam, who try to burn the Quran, who try to do so many bad things. Always be in a positive mood, because the victory of Allah is about to come. It is a matter of sabr. If you are steadfast and patient, as Ibrahim alayhi salam did, when Namrud, the king of Iraq, got tired and sick of him, and decided to throw him in the fire. And see what happened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the order to the fire to get out of her nature of burning. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمٍ. After many days, Ibrahim came out of the fire. Can you imagine? A person to be thrown in the fire, a huge fire. And after days, when the fire is out, Ibrahim is there safe and sound. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. You have a beautiful example in the life of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam have a lot of challenges. Same like us here. And there is no comparison even between what happened to him, what happened to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and what we see here. After getting so old, 86 years old, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him a son, not any son. So the Quran teaches us that when he asked Allah, he didn't ask for any son, but he said, Rabbi habli min as-salihin. Oh Allah, grant me a son who will be one of the righteous. When you grow your children, when you make sure your children grow up in the fold of Islam, you're gonna be so proud of them here and in the life to come. It is our responsibility to bring our children to the masjid, to teach them the Quran and the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to make them good example in their school, in their offices, in their work, in the neighborhood, to make them shining stars for everybody else. And that will never happen when our children are too far, when we do not come to the masajid, when we do not care about Islam. That is why that child, when we take care of him, make him grow up in Islam, we're gonna be so proud of him. Ibrahim alayhi salam asked, رب هب لي من الصالحين فبشرناه بغلام حليم. Allah gave him glad tidings with a child who's gonna be so kind, so humble, so easy with him, to the extent that one night Ibrahim alayhi salam had a dream, a vision, ru'ya from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you must sacrifice your son, a command from Allah. Then Ibrahim alayhi salam took his son, same way he lifted him in the desert as a baby with his mother Hajar. The mother asked him, where are you going? Put us in the desert to die and to go back to Jerusalem. Then he didn't answer. Then she shouted out to him, Allahu amaraka bihada? Did Allah command you to do that? So she want to know if that is an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he said, yes, Allah commanded me to bring you here. رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ. He put them there and asked Allah to look after them. And what happened after that? The source of life, the water, Zamzam, a drop of water that we waste and our children waste. We should teach them the water is the source of life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. Every living creature live and survive from water. So Zamzam, running back from Safa to Marwa 7 times, looking for anything, any sign of water, never been known in that area. And when she came back, I cannot say disappointed, losing every hope that they will survive after they run out of water and food. Then she saw some birds landing in a certain area. When she came back, she found Zamzam coming up, gushing up from under the feet of Ismail alayhi salam. That is Zamzam that until today, thousands of years, the Hujjaj go there, and when they come back, they bring that blessing. That blessing bless the water of Zamzam that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam drank from. That when we go drink from, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ma'u zamzam lima shurib lah. The water of Zamzam work as your niyyah. You make it for knowledge, Allah will give you knowledge. For healing, Allah will give you healing. Then when Ismail alayhi salam become old enough, the time we have hope in him to help out in the rough life in the desert, all of a sudden the order come, you got to sacrifice your son. He came to his son, ya bunayya, inni ara fil manami anni adbahu, fanzur mada tara. My dear son, I saw in the dream that I must sacrifice you. Tell me, what do you think? Look at the righteous son. No question. قال يا أبتي افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. My dear father, do what you have been commanded to. إن شاء الله I'm gonna be صابر. Look at the righteousness. When you work hard to raise a good family, as Ibrahim alayhi salam, honorable family, you will never have hardship, even with no food, no water. Even you take the baby from the mother, she cannot see one word. But did Allah make him to lose his son? No. That is a test, a challenge. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he took his son, as we see nowadays the Hujjaj today, are making the sacrifices. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel alayhi salam down with the ram and told him, hold it Ibrahim, don't sacrifice your son, take this instead. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ya Ibrahim qad saddaqta ar-ru'ya inna kadhalika najzi al-muhsinin. You have fulfilled the vision, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gonna reward you with this prize instead. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. Everything we do in the Eid, the Hujjaj do there in Mecca, it is after the legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim, the one we deserve more than anyone else. The one we mention his name and ask Allah to bless him 17 times a day when we say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim fil alameen innaka hamidun majid. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الله أكبر 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 ولله الحمد. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونتوكل عليه ونستزيده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله السميع البصير وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا البشير النذير. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, everything in our religion is about love. You love Allah, Allah is gonna grant you a family that love you dearly and help you to achieve your goal. When you love Allah, Allah will never let you down, as Ibrahim alayhi salam did. When you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah is gonna give you way out of all hardship. So it is a matter of thanks given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the beauty of our religion, for the brotherhood and the sisterhood, and above all, for the human values that Islam came with, not only for Muslims, but all for all mankind. Islam is the way. Islam is the salvation. Islam is the way not only for Muslims, for everybody. Look back at what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said yesterday in the Khutbah al-Wada'. Ayyuhan nas, O mankind, didn't say, O Muslims, كلكم لآدم وآدم من تراب. All of you belong to Adam, and Adam came from dust. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no one is superior to the other one. All people are equal. Here in America, there is racism. Even in our own Arab and Muslim countries, racism. But Islam came to defeat racism. Islam came to make all mankind, the brothers and sisters in humanity, regardless of their faith or in religion, if they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to achieve our goal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the joy and the happiness to celebrate the day of the bride, the day of salvation, the day of udhiyah. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, خير أيامكم يوم النحر ويوم القر. يوم النحر is today, and يوم القر is tomorrow, where the حجاج stay the whole day and two other days in Mina. اللهم اغفر بفضلك للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعاء يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا همّا إلا فرجته، ولا عيبا إلا سترته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا ميتا إلا رحمته، ولا حاجة إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا رب العالمين. My dear brothers and sisters, have عيد عيد مبارك. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى bless all of you. كل عام وأنتم بخير.